please. Let's keep this thing.
We're up next. Where the hell's our lawyer? She's stuck in traffic. What?
Oh, my God.
Talk to me.
It's some hazmat thing. She's 45 minutes away. Nothing's moving.
Ask Ms. $400 an hour how we're supposed to pull this off without an attorney.
I assume you heard that? Postpone.
Oh, no.
Don't say postpone. If this gets postponed, the video gets postponed, the CD release gets postponed, the tour gets postponed, and millions of dollars get flushed. I have got a director and an entire crew getting paid for standing around. I need Janie Swan, clean and sober, ready to sing tomorrow morning.
Just get here.
God, that would have been great. I mean, getting paid to hang out with Janie Swan.
Shh.
You know, I have all her CDs, even the bootleg Dakota series.
Susan, would you stop, please? What is with you?
I'm sorry, but Janie Swan had a major influence on me through my formative years.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. I bet you stood in front of the mirror and sang and danced and pretended you were her.
No.
I did.
Yes.
That's
disgusting. Number 17639 M. People versus Janie Swan.
She even looks great in prison wear.
Would you stop?
Miss Swan, welcome back. Good to see you behaving yourself for once.
Oh, I've learned a lot about etiquette while locked up in this fine reform facility, Your Honor.
Have you run out of lawyers, Janie? Is there no one left willing to debase himself on your behalf?
Here she is.
What are you doing? Stall. You're in the FBI. Just spout some legal mumbo-jumbo.
And you are Ms...
Go. Cheevers.
Well, come up, Ms. Cheevers. Come up.
Stop.
All the way. Believe me, I understand your reluctance.
Hi.
Hi.
Very well, Ms. Cheevers. Shall we proceed?
Yes. I would like to request a short recess, or a continuance, whichever pleases the court, of about 30 minutes, please. Your Honor.
Very compelling argument, Counselor. The answer is no. Proceed. Miss Swan's last arrest was for violating parole, possession of narcotics, malicious trespassing, and willful destruction of private property. In my opinion, Miss Swan is an unrepentant, incorrigible, unrehabilitated drug abuser. And she represents a threat to everyone and everything around her, especially herself.
Well, we have thought of that, Your Honor. That's why we've hired the finest private investigation firm in the area, Glen Hall Incorporated, to provide 24-hour bonded personal surveillance and protection services for Ms. Swan and surrounding people.
Is Mr. Hall in the courtroom?
Oh, yeah. Here.
Glen Hall?
Yep.
Well, come up, Ms. Hall. Do you honestly believe that you're capable of monitoring Ms. Swan's every move day and night? And ensuring that she stays completely clean and drug-free for this entire proposed furlough?
I do.
Ms. Swan, for your sake, I hope Glen Hall does a good job. Because if they don't, and you break the conditions of your release, I will lock you up. And throw away the key. For good.
The bank with this place.
Well, I think she thought maybe being at your place in Malibu it might be too tempting.
Oh, yeah, she's probably right about that. You know, I know I'm an addict, and I know what's at stake, and I really want to stop. Okay. That's good. It's 5 o'clock, so it's time for a back rub. No. Let me feel that for you, little lady. You take that neat, right?
Please sit down, Mrs. Carnaby.
So, how can I help you?
Well, my husband recently died.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, thank you. He was a very wealthy man, and he left me everything. But his son, from his first marriage, is contesting the will.
I see.
I know that my stepson, I call him that, but he's quite a bit older than I am, actually. I know that he despised Edgar, and Edgar despised him. There wasn't a kind word spoken between them since long before I met Edgar.
Which was when?
Last June.
You weren't married very long.
3 magical months.
If you don't mind me asking, how old was your husband?
83. Very youthful, 83.
I think she really cared for the old guy.
Get a clue, Manny. What's the old geezer's name, anyway?
Edgar Carmody. Made his millions manufacturing women's shoes, if you can believe that.
Whoa, wait. Are you kidding?
No.
His son's name, John, right?
Yeah, he's the one contesting the will. How did you know?
That's the kidnapping case Glenn solved years ago. Remember, the dad was so grateful she got his son back, he gave her $10 million.
That's right.
That's how she started this agency.
That's the guy?
That's him. Edgar Carmody.
Okay. Think of the best orgasm you've ever had.
I don't know if that's a very...
I'm not suggesting you have it. I just want you to think about it.
Okay.
Multiply it by 10.
Oh. I'm not sure that's possible.
Just try it. That's what drugs feel like to an addict.
You're joking.
I wish I was.
Yeah, but that's not worth risking your life for.
No, clearly it's not. So, even though I'm really glad that you're here, and I know we're on the same team,
yeah.
Don't trust me. Do not let me out of your sight for a second.
Okay. Hey.
Relief has arrived. Crab and black bean sauce from Monkey.
Ooh, you gorgeous angel of mercy. How did you know?
Your fan website is extremely thorough. Although, I gotta tell you, quite a dispute has broken out over which butt cheek your tattoo is on. There was a vote.
What side did you come out on?
I thought I'd better remain neutral. You hungry?
Oh, no, that's okay. I'm sure you don't have enough for 3.
Sure we do.
3's my favorite number.
Roberta!
Quit bugging me.
Didn't Carmody give Glenn the money for solving the kidnapping?
Yeah.
It wasn't a loan, right?
That was my understanding.
And mine too, but guess what?
Okay, what are you going on about?
I'm tiptoeing through the old guy's assets, and look, there we are, right there. Glenn Hall, Inc., detective agency.
That can't be.
I know, but Glenn doesn't own the agency. Carmody does, or did. It looks like you, me, and the nipple cam are all part of the inheritance.
We need to talk.
Oh, God.
Hi, Abby. Nice to see you.
Mark says you're being uncooperative.
Is that a quote?
He says you're rejecting all of his ideas.
That's because they suck. He's supposed to be the director, not a meat puppet just doing what he's told.
The label isn't going to pay for any more creative content from a drug addict whose brains are fried, okay? Just stick to the concept we gave you and everything will be fine. You okay?
Yeah, that's normal.
You're kidding me.
Jeez, Glenn, how could you not know this?
It was a loose arrangement with Carmody. I thought he did it that way for tax purposes or something.
This is really serious.
Yeah, I know, Manny. You don't need to tell me that.
Not to mention a conflict of interest
okay,
for us.
Just keep it to yourself for now.
Well, you gotta do something.
Yeah, Manny, that. I know. Can you just be quiet? Let me think about this for a second.
I get it. Glenn Hall. It's the bank.
Yes. What?
Right. No movement. First,
no cancel. That check you gave me with all the pretty zeros bounced.
Just redeposit it tomorrow. I'm sure it's just an accounting glitch. This company has assets in the billions.
Okay, so the check is good. Don't take it personally. Okay, well, if it doesn't clear tomorrow, I'm gonna call that nice judge, have him put Janie back in jail, and all MTV will have to show is a charming video of you with your thumb up your skippy. Oh, and just so you know, I take all my business personally, so don't jerk me around again. Hmm?
I was hoping to see Glenn.
I'm afraid she's out working on a case at the moment.
Well, I'm very impressed with what she's done with the place. Dad would have liked this.
So what are your plans?
Well, as I said before, I'm in a battle with this odious woman, Rose. But I believe ultimately I'll prevail, or at the very least there'll be a settlement in my favor.
I see.
I want to assure you, though, that if I do prevail and this agency reverts to me, nothing will change. I'll keep the same arrangement Dad had with Glenn. Hands off.
I'm sure Glenn will be pleased to hear that.
The reason I came by, is I thought maybe you could help. You know, maybe dig something up on Rose. Frankly, it behooves you if you want to keep this agency intact. Because I guarantee you, if the assets go to her, she'll liquidate. She doesn't understand investment. All she wants is cash.
Stop! 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 Stop!
What?
This stinks. This is horrible. Look at this. Look at what I'm wearing. I look like an idiot.
I don't know what you're thinking. This just doesn't work.
Oh, it doesn't.
Does it?
I'm just trying to do what Abby wants.
Screw Abby. I can fix this. You guys, what do you think of this?
It's not so good,
right?
The lighting's really bad.
Yeah. Pretty spooky looking, right?
Yeah. And it's static. You need movement or something. It's bad.
It's static, right? We're going handheld on this one. Glenn, get a guitar. I really need someone to play off of. Come on up.
1, 2, 3. In the dark of the day, you're a perfect stranger. You know I saw you yesterday. I bet you thought you were the perfect stranger. I bet you thought you were the perfect stranger. I want you leather.
fooled out there. If you'd asked me, I would have thought you were playing.
Yeah. When I was a little kid, there was this guy who had a nylon string gram, this weird wooden guitar. And whenever I was alone, I would take it and go in my room and turn on the radio and teach myself how to play. I thought there was nothing in the world cooler or sexier than a woman with a guitar.
Why'd you stop playing?
I don't know. Stuff happens. You wake up one day and you realize that life is no longer about possibility, but more about diminishing returns, I guess.
Pretty bleak view of the world.
Well, it's a pretty bleak world to view. I mean, in my business, I'm always going after the bad guy, or I go after the good guy who turns out to be the bad guy. But I'm always seeing people at their worst. All the time.
And?
For the first time, I think I hate what I do. God. I swore I would never let this happen to me. I let this happen to me.
Life's what happens to you when you're busy making other plans.
I better get back. Here. I had an awesome time.
Good.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
She's gonna fire me. I know it.
I can placate Abby.
Yeah, do it her way.
Look, you know what? All Abby really cares about is just selling more products. So I'm just gonna give her a new song. That's gonna make her happy.
You're gonna write a new song?
Look, Abby doesn't know this, and nobody knows this. I've been writing and recording in my own studio for years. I have hundreds of songs.
Wow, that must be worth a fortune.
Whoever has the songs gets the money.
Yep. That's why I'm just gonna give her one.
Well, it's gonna take more than one song to make her happy this time.
Hello?
Get rid of her, but don't tell her why.
Stinks, Glenn.
Yeah, well, so does unemployment. Hey, you said it yourself. It's a conflict of interest. Just do it.
Dropping my case? I don't understand.
Look, it's just that we're very busy, and I guess we got overloaded. I just can't give the case the attention it deserves.
Oh, my God. He got to you, didn't he?
No.
John, he bought you off.
No, that's not it at all.
Oh, what is it, then? What else could it be?
I can't tell you.
No, he got to you. I can tell. This happens all the time. Hates me.
Please. Don't cry. It's all right. I'll help you.
You will?
Unofficially. Off the books. Secretly.
About time. Hey, you're an hour late. What happened?
Don't ask. Where is she?
In the bedroom.
When was the last time you checked her?
A couple hours ago.
I'm kidding.
Oh, Glenn, come on. She's sleeping. Glenn! Oh.
You guys want to hear me play Stairway to Heaven?
I think I remember how to play that.
Ugh, my head is killing me.
Not your own fault, bucko.
I found those pills in the bathroom.
Yeah, and who jammed them down your throat?
Glenn.
What? Don't Glenn me. I know you're always saying, oh, Janie's trying to stay clean right now. Well, I'm sorry, I don't buy it. What, the drug fairy put some Percodan at the side of the sink? She still took it.
You know, don't talk about me like I'm not in this room.
Shut up and drink your juice.
No, and I won't be treated like someone to be clucked over like a child. I'm gonna get dressed. You do think I can get dressed on my own, don't you? What crawled up your colon?
The guy who originally gave me the money for the agency, he died. And his heirs are contesting the will, of which the agency is listed as part of the assets.
Oh, Glenn, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry, too. I mean, what about you? You just left the FBI, you gave up your pension. Right? I mean, you did leave the FBI.
Oh, yeah.
You didn't?
Mm.
You're still part of the Bureau?
I took a 3-week leave of absence. I didn't know if I was gonna like private investigating.
Smart. Very smart.
Huh. 7 years ago, loving son John attempted a hostile takeover of Edgar's company.
See? He is a horrible person.
Well, that's not the worst of it. In a letter to the board of directors, he called his father morally bankrupt, said he was ashamed of him and that he no longer considered him part of the family.
God, poor Edgar. No wonder he cut John out of the will.
Yeah, but the takeover failed. I mean, the board tried to hush it up to protect the company and stock price.
So what does this mean?
Means you're my new boss.
You're kidding me.
No. This case is sunk.
You are some kind of genius or something.
Please, I'm...
No, just... I mean it. And you helped me when no one else would.
It was my pleasure.
You did. What can I ever do to repay you?
Don't liquidate the agency. It means a lot to Glenn and me.
Of course I won't. The doors stay open. What else?
You know, I hate to say this, but it is our job to bust her.
If I thought it would do her any good, I'd say go ahead. What does it do? It ruins the video, it ruins the tour, it's gonna ruin her. And besides, I cannot help thinking somebody planted those pills on purpose so she would get busted.
Yeah, there's a word for people like you.
What's that supposed to mean, people like me?
People like you who make excuses for people like her.
Okay, enabler. Glenn, the word's enabler. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Just spare me your psychobabble. Please, let's just get her cleaned up. She goes to work, she does her job. Everybody's happy. No harm, no foul.
Where is she?
She's inside, but don't worry.
Oh, you're not worried. I redeposited Abby's check. It bounced again. I told her she's not going to cough up the money, then we're out of here. I swear, I'm never dealing with music people again.
Wait, look, we're part of Janie's release deal. She's got to pay us.
Susan, I've had experience with record labels before. She's the type of executive who doesn't like to pay. I say we cut our losses and get out of here.
But what about Janie?
What about Janie? I love her. I adore her, but I'm sorry. I have a business I'm trying to save.
Oh, this does not make any sense. You know, Abby was just here. She was fawning all over Janie. I think we should stay here tonight, see if it doesn't sort itself out tomorrow.
Susan, we are officially off the case.
Well, then I will do it unofficially.
Forget it. We can't risk the liability. If Janie pulls another little stunt like she did last night, we're going to lose the bond on top of not getting paid. Besides, Abby says she'll take care of Janie.
What, Abby?
Look, I'm not thrilled about this either, but we have no choice. Come on, let's say goodbye and get out of here.
Something new.
It's beautiful.
Good night, Abby.
Good night.
Hey, guess what? We won. Rose owns the agency.
Really? Huh. Okay, well. Well, what do you plan on doing with it, if you don't mind my asking?
No, don't worry. I'm not going to sell or anything.
That's good.
Isn't it great?
And Glenn, with your help and support, and with Manny here as my teacher, I plan to become a PI myself.
Wow.
Why don't you have some champagne with us?
Sure.
Oh, I'll get you a glass. Oh, where do I keep them?
You can see how this would not be good news for me.
It could be worse. I mean, we could have a for sale sign out front, Glenn.
Still up?
Oh yeah, I can't sleep. I'm having the weirdest dreams. I dreamt that I was on stage. I was playing this song. I didn't know what the chords were. Crowd was booing at me.
And
I felt like getting high.
Why don't you?
Why don't I what?
Wanna play?
Gee, Abby. Why are you doing this to me?
You always said you work better on the nod.
No, that's what you always said, but it's not true.
What can it hurt?
Abby,
go on. Take it. You've worked so hard, you deserve this. It's okay, Janie. We all have our vices. I'll leave you alone. Worried about Janie, so we thought we'd stop by and check on her.
I'm so glad you're here. I was just about to call an ambulance.
What's wrong?
I don't know where Janie got the smack, but she's dead. I just checked on her a minute ago. The dose must have been too hot for her to handle. I was just about to call 911 when you knocked on the door.
Took you long enough to get here.
Hmm.
She looks pretty good for a dead woman.
Where's the syringe?
Right there. How could you do it to me, Abby? Why would you do that to me? Detective McCormick's on his way over here.
He could ask you all those pesky little questions.
I don't know what you're talking about. Janie, you are just back to your same old tricks and excuses, but I will not defend you this time. I'm sorry.
I don't need you. I beat you. And I beat heroin. I lie in this bed, waiting for Susan and Glenn to get here, and I knew that there was a syringe full of smack right there. And it was a tug of war for me, but I won. I won this.
Abby just wanted to get her hands on all those recordings Janie's been making over the years. I just thought she was gonna strong arm her. I never imagined she'd do anything like this.
So she was worth more to the record company dead than alive?
Basically.
I have nothing to say.
Oh, that's okay. Mark already rolled over. You gave Janie a hot dose, hoping she would OD, making it look like an accidental overdose. Then you planned on releasing all of Janie's music on your label, making millions. With Janie dead, the value of her recordings immediately goes up.
That makes no sense.
Oh, really?
Really? Why would I hire private detectives to watch her if I planned on killing her?
You tried getting rid of them. You figured if you bounced enough checks, they'd disappear, problem solved.
These stories are always surfacing in the recording business. Hendrix, Jim Morrison, no one ever believes them.
What if I told you we turned up the dealer you bought the stuff from?
I'd say you're bluffing.
Really? The Glenn Hall agency found it. You should try hiring them sometimes, but they are a little expensive and they do like to be paid.
I have something I have to tell you.
I know, you think I'm moving too fast with Rose. Look, Roberta,
I do think you're moving too fast. I mean, this woman just came into your life and already she's got your head spun around six ways to Sunday.
I think you're right.
Huh?
I mean, that's why I always need you around here, Roberta. I'd be lost without you.
Wait, now what are you talking about?
I was just thinking that ever since me, you, and Glenn got here, it's really been me and you, hasn't it? You're my partner. I just want you to know that I'd do anything for you, Roberta. I hope you know that.
Manny, I don't know what to say.
What were you gonna say before I interrupted you?
Can wait.
Oh, come on, Roberta. I was just...
Manny. I'm leaving the agency.
I know.
You know. And you put me through all of that? I can't believe you.
I meant what I said.
I just don't know if I'm doing the right thing. Mm-hmm.
Tell me about it.
Manny, I'm gonna be the technical advisor on a new show about private eyes.
Roberta, that's incredible. That's been a good TV show about private eyes since Moonlighting. Right?
Takes place in LA.
So we'll get to see each other.
No, we shoot in Vancouver.
Oh.
It's gonna be kind of funny. Well, not too funny. With lots of high-tech gadgets.
That's where you come in.
That's where I come in. And unfortunately, this is where I go out. I have a meeting with the producers in an hour. See, we start shooting next month, so I gotta go.
I mean, it's not like we'll never see each other again, right?
I'm gonna miss you.
You too.
Chicago, Cleveland, Syracuse, and Buffalo. God, how many cities in this tour?
It's like 35 and 50 days.
Yikes.
There's half a chance the band's gonna make it out alive.
Well, if you survive, drop me a line. Let me know how you're doing.
Why don't you come on the road with us?
Yeah, right.
Why not?
Why not?
Why not? Glenn, listen to me. You don't like your business. The first time in your life, you don't like what you're doing. So make a change. Just take a leap.
Janie,
Everything you're saying
makes sense.
Yeah, on a certain level, it makes sense, but
it scares the hell out of you.
Yeah, really. I mean, it's flattering, but what am I supposed to do? I'm not a professional musician.
You can play rhythm guitar. You look great in leather. I really want you in my band.
You're serious?
Yeah, I'm serious.
I can't. I've got responsibilities. I have a business to run. I just can't up and leave.
Yes, you can.
Hi.
Hi. I'm glad I caught you. I was hoping you could sign this for me.
Oh, you are such a geek.
Oh, get a pen.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's pretty cute.
Aww.
So, Glenn, I'm leaving. I'm going back to Washington.
D.C.?
She's an FBI agent.
Huh?
Long story, don't ask.
But I am not going back to the FBI.
Really?
I mean, I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I just know it'd be a mistake to go back.
Good for you.
Thanks.
Oh, that's gotta be for me. All right, now listen to me. Here, you take this.
Wait.
Glenn, I'm out of here, okay? And if you change your mind, you know where to find me. And I'm serious.
This one?
Oh, God. All right, girls. Say... Cheeseball.
Cheeseball.
Let me just talk to her.
She wants to fire me. What happened to her needing all my help and support?
She found a night school that teaches private investigating. She thinks it'll be quicker. Look, I can change her
mind. No. You know, I think this is a sign.
Sign? What's it say?
It says walk.
Come on, Glenn, you can't leave. I wouldn't know what to do without you. It'd be no fun. Besides, what are you gonna do?
I don't know. Manny, even though you kind of betrayed me, I still love you. But this place is killing me. I gotta get out of here.
I love you too. I can't believe you're leaving.
Oh, keep in touch.
Well, wait a minute. You'll call me and let me know where you are, right?
Just remember what the sign says.
Walk.
You keep saying you got something for me. Something you call love, but confess. You've been a messin' where you shouldn't been a messin'. Now someone else is getting all your best. But these boots are made for walking, and that's just what they do. And one of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Keep lying when you ought to be truthing. You keep losing when you ought to not bet. You keep saving when you ought to be a-changing. And what's right is right, but you ain't been right yet. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. You keep playing where you shouldn't be playing. And you keep thinking that you'll never get burned. I just found me a brand new box of matches.
Yeah.
And what do you know, you ain't had time to learn. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. Cause one of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you.
Are you ready, boots?
Start walking.
what can I do? One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you.
Get out of here.
You stinker.